Hello everyone, welcome to today's current affairs session of Civilspedia. The topics we are going to see is Fugitive Economic Offender, New Horizons Mission, Changey Mission, and Climate Change Driven Events. Fugitive Economic Offender. The name itself, the economic offender means the person, any person who has committed an economic offense is called an economic offender. And this term, the fugitive, means the person who is trying to escape from the country in order to escape from the jurisdiction of the country. So this fugitive economic offender means a person who has done economic crimes, and in order to escape from the judicial process, he or she has been escaped from the country or not willing to coming back to the country to undergo this procedure of judicial with respect to the economical crimes. So this Fugitive Economic Offender Act, the recent context with respect to this one is this act has recently passed, and this act has recently, the special court has declared Vijay Mallya as the first Indian to be a fugitive economic offender. So we will see about what this act aim and what are the provisions of this act. So first one is the aim of this act is to contain these persons who are escaping from the India to escape, to evade from this juridical proceedings of this economic crimes. So that is the ultimate aim of this economic Fugitive Economic Offender Act. And this act is applicable only if the value of the economic crime is above the 100 crores. Then only this act will be applicable. So if the value of economic crime is below the 100 crores, then this act will not come under this. Then the person will not be tried under this act. So according to this act, the special court will be set up under this Prevention of Money Laundering Act of 2002. This special court will have the legitimate power to declare a person as a fugitive economic offender. If a person has been declared as a fugitive economic offender, what are the proceedings they will take over is, they will issue a notice for within at least they have to come to country back so that the judicial process of the economic crimes will be carried on. If the person doesn't come within the first 6 weeks tough time, then the court will be declared the person as a fugitive economic offender. And apart from that, the court will also, this special court, will also appoint a administrator to oversee the confiscated property of the person, as well as the binomi properties of the fugitive economic offender will also come under. So the administrator will oversee all these things. The next thing is, this under this act, the person, the fugitive economic offender, will not get into claim of, will not defend himself against any civil rights. So not only the person, but also the company in which this person, this fugitive economic offender, is a majority stakeholder, then that company will also could not claim any civil rights. Only if the person, the fugitive economic offender, returned back to the country and started to undergo this civil proceedings, this criminal proceedings under this court, then only this civil crime, civil rights will be claimed by the person. So till the person doesn't come back to the country, he or she will not claim any civil crimes. So apart from that, what is the criticism with respect to this fugitive economic offender is, first and foremost thing is, this act has said that the person, the special court, can make an administrator to oversee the confiscated property, and it can sell the property also. But this act doesn't tell how the money that has been retrieved from this confiscated property will be utilized. Because as per the fugitive economic offender, there will be many stakeholders who have been affected by this fugitive economic offender. So how the money will be shared among these people by selling the confiscated property, that this act was be silent in that. And second important thing is, by selling of the property before the person is really get convicted in the court is against the principle of natural justice. Because only when a person is convicted before the court, then only the action can be taken down. But this act says that action will be taken priorly before the person is get convicted. So this act is against this principle of natural justice. These are the two criticisms with respect to this Fugitive Economic Offender Act. And second topic is New Horizon Missions. The New Horizon Mission is nothing but it is an NASA's recent mission of that has been launched in 2006. This is nothing but it is an interplanetary space probe that has been launched by NASA to study the Pluto and this outer Kuiper Belt objects. So the major objective right now is this Kuiper Belt object, studying this Kuiper Belt objects. So recently this New Horizon has sent a picture of this Ultima Thule. This Ultima Thule has been discovered by Hubble Telescope in 2004. It is nothing but it is a rock, icy rock, that is revolving around this, revolving the Kuiper Belt in a circular orbit. So this Ultima Thule has been 4 billion miles away from this solar system, 4 billion from the Earth. And the meaning of this Ultima Thule is beyond the borders of known plan, known world. And the next topic is this Chang'e mission. This Chang'e mission is this is a mission that has been done by this China. They have launched, they have landed, successfully landed the spacecraft on the far side of the moon. Still no, we, no country has ever landed on the far side of the moon. So many countries have taken the picture of the far side of the moon, but no country has been landed in the spacecraft on the far side of the moon. So China is the first country to land on the far side of the moon. And this is for Chang'e 4 mission has been landed on this far side of the moon. As per the previous mission is, this Chang'e 1 and 2 missions are just orbiter that has been move around this moon, while Chang'e 3 and 4 will have a lander that will land on the moon, and not only it will study the moon surface, but also it carries this tomato, potato and a flowering seed and a silkworm eggs, so that it will understand how the biodiversity or how it's possible for this environment that is feasible for the living organisms to live. So it has been taken into a sealed container. These things have been taken into a sealed container, and it has been undergoes this biodiversity biological experiment will be conducted on this far side of the moon. And this, in future, the China will going to launch Chang'e 5 and 6 that will bring back the samples from the moon, so that it will study in depth about how this moon has been formed, whether it is possible for a living organisms to live in the moon. And apart from that, China has the goal of building an outpost on the south pole of the moon by 2030. So these are the missions, this Chang'e 5 and 6 missions, and this outpost, building an outpost on the southern pole of the moon, will be completed, launched by this 2030. And the last important editorial topic is climate change driven events. The recent issue that many of the countries are facing this climate change problems, and India is one of the countries that has been severely affected by this climate change. The recent report of a World Bank said that the climate change alone cost for India's 2.8% of GDP. That shows is a huge amount of money has been spent by India for this due to this climate change events. And this IPCC report recently has said that we have to limit the temperature rise by 1.5 degrees Celsius. Earlier report has said by 2 degrees Celsius, but this recent report has said by limit this temperature rise by 1.5 degrees Celsius, because already we have reached this pre-industrial level of 1 degree rise. Still now we have only 0.5 degrees Celsius of rise within this 2100. If we go beyond this 1.5 degrees Celsius rise, temperature rise, then it will going to affect a huge much of this biodiversity, because so many wildlife will be get affected by this 1.5 degrees Celsius of rise. So what are the impacts of this rise? We will see it. So, and recently the Global Carbon Project has said that this global carbon emission of has been launched, has been in this recent Paris summit, that recent summit of Conference of Party of Climate Change has said that this global carbon emission has been reached an all-time high in 2018, with India's contribution to the global carbon emission is 6.3% in 2018. That shows India started to get increasing this carbon emission in 2018. And in overall, comparing to the last century, this 2018 makes this highest level of a carbon emission. That shows we are not properly taking the steps, even though we have so many of agreements earlier we have made to have contained this carbon emissions. This shows that we will have to make steps to contain this carbon emissions immediately, because there is no other go. The climate change is driven events is so much fast, and we are facing, each and every country is facing the negative impacts of this climate change. So we will see what are the impacts of this climate change. The recent of the Kerala flood and this low agriculture productivity of India, and there's so much of loss of our biodiversity, especially we are losing the more and more traditional crops, and as well as this many of the wildlife coming under the threat due to this habitat loss, and in many other things of a climate change driven events. And what are the global commitments that India has made, and what are the other agreements that India has been signed, and it is how it is India's performing in that agreement? We will see into it. The first thing is the global commitments of India. The first is this Paris Agreement. In that, India has contributed that intended nationally determined contribution. In that, three important things is in. First one is this, India has said it will achieve the target, that is, it will create a carbon sink to get to sequester the carbon up to 2.5 to 3 billion tons of a carbon dioxide. And second target under this INDC, India has said in Paris Agreement, is it will reduce this emission intensity of a GDP to the range of 33 to 35% by 2030 from the 2005 industrial level. And third important target that has been set under this INDC is is 40% of electricity of India will be met by non-fossil fuels. So these are the three agreements that these are the three commitments that India has been made in this Paris Agreement. And as per this global this carbon sink, that is 2.52, creating a carbon sink to absorb a carbon from 2.5 to 3 billion tons of carbon dioxide. India is lagging far in this carbon sink target because we cannot make that much of a forestry. Even though India's forest level has been raised from 23% to 24% of a geographical area, coming under the forest area, but still India cannot make this 2.5 to 3 billion tons of a carbon dioxide sequestration by using this simple forestry scheme. So we need to have focus on other schemes. For that, India has introduced this catchment treatment plan. It is nothing but how to catch this atmospheric carbon dioxide into the organic carbon within the soil. So by creating more check dams or by having this, how the soil water content has to be filled so that more and more carbon dioxide can be contained into this soil. So these are the catchment treatment plan that has been India is planning to implement apart from this forestry goal. And third important thing that is India is moving towards this global agreement to Paris summit is this CAMPA agreement, this compensation. Afforestation Management Planning and Authority Fund, as well as this National Adaptation Fund to handle this climate change. And then this National Afforestation Program, how to increase this India's carbon cover. So that green cover is increasing, then the carbon sequestration will be possible so that we will meet the target of this 2.5 to 3 billion tons of carbon dioxide sequestration. And apart from that, India has created this Green India Mission under National Action Plan on Climate Change. And India has created this city forest under this Nagar Van Udyan Yojana. So creating more and more cities, forest. So that will have a very beautiful effect on this city, as well as it will change the landscape use of the city, thereby making the reducing the stress level of the people, as well as giving a good contribution to the environment. So this city forest is one of the crucial thing that India has to focus on. And by combining this city forest with this smart city mission will make the India to transform into another level, that by being a global example, it can make how a city can be developed into a greenery space so that it will contain this carbon emission, thereby reducing their negative environmental impact. And apart from that, India has developed this desertification and land degradation atlas by using this Department of Space of ISRO. So we have launched an ISRO exclusively for this GIS, Geographical Information System. Using that, we have made this land degradation atlas so that we will study how this land degradation process has been taken place in India, how we can contain this desertification process. So because in global level, this desertification is one of the negative things that this climate change is driving at the faster level. So Sahara and many other desertification has properly taken. So India has to take an example from that Sahara desertification process, and thereby how we can contain this Thar desert desertification is, and spreading on loss of this biodiversity due to this desertification, we have to contain it. And apart from that, this Bureau of Energy Efficiency, they have launched India's first State Energy Efficiency Preparedness Index. That shows, this index will show how each and every state is preparing for to meet this energy efficiency target so that it will have a positive global environmental impact. And apart from that, Himachal Pradesh is the first state in India to have done this climate smart agriculture profile. Thereby, it will revamp its how the climate agriculture has been coincided with this climate change, so that it will have this smart climate agriculture profile. And apart from that, this Bihar, along with this Borlaug Institute of South Asia, has planned to create 100 climate smart villages in Bihar, so that the more and more climate smart villages only can handle this negative impacts of climate change. Thereby, this villages will not only part of a problem, it will be part of the solution. So how this village can add contribution to this global climate changes. So it will reduce this negative impact of the climate changes, and thereby they themselves be a sustainable model of a smart climate villages. And apart from that, recently Orissa is the first state to have taken, launch a 5-year action plan of how to deal with this climate change. And apart from this, another important thing is the Delhi government, health department of this Delhi government has prepared a roadmap on how to deal with the seasonal changes. Because this health department is one of the things that has severely affected this climate changes. Due to the climate changes, more and more new diseases started to spread. And it is spread in this endemic manner and pandemic manner also. So it started to spread at a viral manner. So they need to have a roadmap of if there is a dengue fever or any flu diseases started to spread, how fastly they can make a decision so that it will be contained to not to be spread to a faraway area. So this Delhi Health Department has prepared a roadmap of how to manage these diseases as per this climate changes or seasonal changes. And apart from that, this India has been ranked as 4 in this global climate risk index that has been prepared by this German watch. That shows India is now vulnerable in this global climate risk. And India, most of the people are under the BPL, below poverty line. So this climate change will make a more hidden their livelihood and as well as loss their property. So that will make the people to be suffer a lot and making to fall into the poverty vicious cycle. So we need to have taken proper steps, this adaptation and mitigation steps properly, so that only many people, it will contain or it will stop many people falling into this poverty line, below poverty line. And apart from this, what are the things we have to focus on, this climate change driven things? The first and foremost thing is this having a cleaner air, because it is a vital thing that is obstructing India from costing this GDP. So health of India is severely affected due to this air pollution. So first thing is, for that, India has earmarked 300 crore rupees for a Pan-India Clean Air Program. So the target of this Pan-India Clean Air Program is to reduce the carbon emission, that is air pollution, by 20 to 30% by 2024, by having 2019 as the base year. So by having 2019 as base year, what is the pollution in the 2019 that will take into base year? With that thing, 20 to 30% of the air pollution has been reduced by 2024. And apart from that, this department has said that there was no data, exclusive data, how the death or any other disease that has been exclusively linked to due to this air pollution. So this data is not available. So they have started to analyze or do the research to study how this air pollution is contributing to disease or death. And next important thing is with respect to climate change is the river. Because water body is one of the crucial things that is has been severely impacted by this climate change. So we have formed this Namami Gange program, which is one of the vital program of India. So to rejuvenate the Ganga and many other river programs also we have formulated to how to protect this watershed so that it will contain this drying up of the rivers as well as the pollution of the rivers can be contained. So then for the reducing the pollution of the rivers to be contained, we need to divert this drainage into a proper sewage treatment plan, because most of the drainages we are let into directly into the rivers. So we have to reduce it that. And apart from this, the threat from the sea level rise is another major threat under this climate change driven event. So recently we have announced this coastal regulation zone notification of 2018. This regulation CRZ has made diluted. So our 7,500 kilometer coastal line areas now is more prone to construction activities to enhance this economical activity. But this will give a threat to the sea level rise, because more and more sea level rise started to intrude into this coastal zone areas, and it is one of the very dynamic area where the biodiversity is very high. And because of this ecotone effect, and this zone when started to undergo severe construction or real estate activities, then it will going to affect this most estuaries or coastal area based biodiversity. So we need to have proper regulation or proper notification or regulation how to contain this coastal zone areas negative impact. And apart from this, this dams is another important thing of this climate change things, because India is frequently going to face this dams problem. So that the recent issue of this Kerala flood and many other Chennai flood, the majority of the flood right now is because of this improper management of our dams. So we need to have safety of the large dams is one of the crucial thing that is threatening this India's security. So we have assigned this World Bank, along with the World Bank, we have made this dam rehabilitation and improvement program. So that contains this, how this health of the dam can be maintained so that it will not give a negative impact or it will not be a threat to the India's security. And apart from that, how we have to simplify this environment regulation, because this environment regulation is one of the things that is so mystifying this. So we need to demystify this environmental regulation so that each and everybody can easily understand. For example, the solid waste management rules has been framed, but it is not up to a simpler manner, so that many urban local bodies cannot go up to the level of this solid waste management rules. So we need to make a simplify so that everyone, each and everyone can understand what is the regulation law is saying. So it will make many people to comply with this law. So we need to simplify and make this Environment Regulation Act is more popular. So each and everybody has to know about this. What is the Environment Regulation Act is saying? So these are the things we have to notice with respect to this climate change driven events. With that thing, we will end today's current session. Thank you. Have a nice day. Comment and share on this channel.